discussed the temporal behaviors of dependent variables. In this video, we will study how a parameter affects the dynamics of a system. Here is a simplified model for fishes growing in a tank. As the growth is restricted by space and resources, I have used a logistic growth term, kx into 1 minus x by c. Here c is the carrying capacity. We are removing the fishes at a fixed rate r. Like k and c, r is also a parameter of our model. In this video, I will investigate how r affects the steady state of this system. So let's calculate the steady state. Set dx dt equal to 0 and rearrange the terms. We get the steady state value of x equal to k into c plus minus square root of k square c square minus 4rkc, the whole thing divided by 2k. When 4rkc is greater than k square c square, then we have a negative number under the square root. So the steady state is a complex number, which is unrealistic. Rearranging the terms, I can say when r is greater than kc by 4, the system does not have a real steady state. Now consider 4rkc equal to k square c square. In this case, we get 0 under the square root. And there is only one solution for x. Rearranging the terms, I can say when r is equal to kc by 4, the system has only one steady state at x equal to c by 2. What about r less than kc by 4? In this case, the system has two real steady states. The first one is x equal to kc plus square root of k square c square minus 4rkc, the whole thing divided by 2k. And the second steady state is kc minus, notice I have a minus sign here, kc minus square root of k square c square minus 4rkc, the whole thing divided by 2k. Similarly, there are two steady states, x equal to 0 and c, when r is equal to 0. A negative value of r is unrealistic, so I will not consider a negative value for r. Let me jot down what we have got till now. When r is greater than kc by 4, then there is no real steady state. When r is equal to kc by 4, there is only one steady state. But when r lies between 0 and kc by 4, then there are two steady states. So, the number of steady states of this system is changing with the value of r. Here I represent that graphically. We have r in the horizontal axis and the steady state values of x on the vertical one. We have a parabola with the vertex at r equal to kc by 4. There, the steady state is x equal to c by 2. Beyond this point, there is no steady state. Below this point, the system has two steady states. The blue part of the parabola is the higher steady state of the system, that is x equal to kc plus square root of k square c square minus 4rkc by 2k. Whereas the yellow line is for the lower steady state, x equal to kc minus square root of k square c square minus 4rkc, whole thing divided by 2k. So, a parameter r is affecting the number of possible steady states in our model. Will it also affect the stability of these steady states? Let's check that. Our model is a simple one-dimensional problem. I will use a derivative-based method to check the stability of the steady state. You may use any other method. Here, I will calculate the derivative of the right-hand side function of the ODE at a steady state. If the derivative is negative, then that steady state is stable. If that derivative is positive, then the steady state is unstable. Get the derivative of our function. It is equal to k minus 2k by c into x. Now, I will plug different steady state values of x in this derivative to ascertain the stability. For the higher steady state, x equal to kc plus square root of k square c square minus 4rkc divided by 2k, plug that value in k minus 2k by c into x. So the value of that derivative at that steady state is minus, note the minus sign, minus square root of k square c square minus 4rkc divided by c. This is negative. That means the steady state along this upper blue line is stable. We will use the same procedure for the other steady state along the yellow line. For this one, x is equal to kc minus square root of k square c square minus 4rkc divided by 2k. As we see, the derivative of the function in our ODE is positive for this steady state. So this particular steady state is unstable. So I can say that R, a parameter in our model, affects both the number of possible steady states and also the stability of these steady states. This phenomena is called bifurcation. In general, for some dynamical systems, the qualitative behavior changes with variation of a parameter. By change in qualitative behavior, we mean A, change in number of steady states, and B, change in the stability of these steady states. Change in either of these two or both will change the phase portrait of the system. Such qualitative changes in the dynamics of the system depending upon a parameter is called bifurcation. That particular parameter is called the control parameter. For our fish in a tank model, R is the control parameter. Bifurcation is often visualized on a bifurcation diagram. In a bifurcation diagram, the control parameter is on the horizontal axis, and the steady states of a dependent variable is shown on the vertical axis. The value of the control parameter where the bifurcation happens is called the bifurcation point. In the fish tank problem, the bifurcation point is R equal to KC by 4. In a bifurcation diagram, the stable and unstable steady states are represented by different colors or by different line patterns. In our diagram, we have used blue and yellow colors. You can also place arrows near the steady states to represent stability. In this diagram, for example, both the arrows on the blue line for the stable steady state are pointing towards the steady state. For the unstable one, those arrows are pointing in the opposite directions. That's all for this video. We'll learn about different types of bifurcation in the next one. Happy learning!